My name is Shauna Beland. I'm the Director of Energy Programs and Policy at the Rhode Island Office of Energy Resources. Our office has worked with a couple of different community-based organizations over the years. We've spent a lot of time working out in the community and being out in the spaces where the people live that we're trying to serve. So some of our environmental justice areas, some of our disadvantaged communities, if they request any of our help for, just a one-on-one, they want to meet us in person. If they think there's a great tabling opportunity for us to provide education to their community members, we'll absolutely make the time and try to be there and help really build that relationship with the community. Working with community-based organizations has helped our office in two ways. One is to provide transparency about what we're trying to do and making sure that we get feedback from the communities that we're trying to serve. And then the second piece, we've added equity to our mission in the past couple of years and thinking about what that really means for us as an office and how we're going to go out into the community. A lot of the community-based organizations that we have in Rhode Island are small. They don't have a lot of capacity in terms of staff and resources. And we recognize that. We know that they're not going to have a lot of time to devote to providing feedback. So doing things like meeting them where they are, being able to provide interview forums for feedback. I have two recommendations for states that might be interested in working with community-based organizations. The first is if there is any budget for a dedicated staff person. We have an energy justice program manager in our office. He spent a considerable portion of the first year of his work going out into the community, working with communities on developing and drafting some of the community benefit plans that were required for a lot of the federal funding that's coming into the state. So he is develop some of those relationships, built upon them, and that will be incredibly important for building trust and being able to maintain that trust over the next couple of years as we're actually implementing some of those community benefit plans. The second recommendation I have is just patience. There's a lot of pressure from both the federal government, from our state government to try to really get a lot of the funding out the door. We just want to create programs in an equitable way to really spend the time designing programs that will make a difference at the end of the day and helping customers realize significant bill savings. There's patience that's needed for working with those organizations because they're so capacity limited. They don't have a lot of staff. They don't have a lot of resources. And as they have multiple agencies and other organizations trying to get their attention,